Today, we'll be showing you a trick on how to better manage your task dependencies in Zoho Projects. And that is using a Gantt chart. If you'd like to see more videos like this, subscribe and press that bell icon to stay updated with our video tutorials.
To find the Gantt chart by project, click on some particular project under Recent Projects tab, or by clicking on the Projects tab, you can navigate to some particular project. After that, navigate to the Gantt and Reports tab in the top menu and choose Gantt chart option from the drop-down menu. Now we are under milestone view and we can see all tasks which are related to some milestones or to some tasks. So such milestone and task list relation is reflected on the chart view. And now we can see little amount of tasks because we are under my open tasks view. To see all tasks under some particular project, choose all open view from the drop-down menu. And now all tasks under some particular project are reflected on the chart. Milestones are colored in red, task lists are colored in gray, tasks are colored in blue, and there is one subtask on the project, prepare the soul, and this subtask is colored in green. If some task lists, tasks, or subtasks are not related to some particular milestone, you will see none in the milestone view here, and there won't be any red line under such tasks or task lists. If we choose chronology view, then we will see only tasks or subtasks in their chronological order. On such chronology view, milestones and task lists won't be reflected, so you will see the clear picture only of tasks or subtasks entities. Moving back to milestone view, there is also the possibility to set the task dependencies, and there are two types of dependencies, predecessor tasks and successor tasks. Predecessor tasks are the tasks which should be done first, and then successor task is the task that can be started only after a predecessor task is completed. By clicking on some arrow at the beginning of the task or at the end of the task, we will see the setup window with two options to set the predecessor or successor of the task. In such case, let's define the logic of some tasks order. We have the kickoff task, then operations task, and SMM task. So we would like to set the order of such tasks so that kickoff should be done first. Only after kickoff is completed, we can start with operations tasks, and after that, we can move to SMM tasks. To define such dependency logic, click on the arrow, and we will set the successor task for the kickoff task. Click successor, add successor button, and insert operations task name. Here it is, the operations task, set dependency, and after that the dependency is set between kickoff task and operations task. Then, to set the dependencies between operations and SMM, click on the arrow at the end of the operation task and set successor. Add successor, and there is the same actions which we done before. Set dependency, and now, as you see, the SMM task was a little bit moved further, and there is the time lag set between the operations and SMM task. There is the possibility to set the time lags or delete such time lags between the tasks. Click Set Time Lag, and you can insert the amount of days between the tasks. So now 2 days lag is added after kickoff task and before the operations task. The same thing with the successor time lag. For example, we can add 4 days. And now, such 4 days time lag was added after operations task and before SMM task. So now, the logic is that the kickoff task is the predecessor one, and then operations task is the successor task for kickoff task. Then, operations task is the predecessor task for SMM task, and such SMM task is the successor for operations task. So by clicking on the beginning of the SMM task, we will see that there is the predecessor, and no successors. And the predecessor of SMM task is the operations task itself. So the logic is that only when we complete the kickoff task, the operations task can be started and then closed. If kickoff task is not closed, then operations task and SMM task couldn't be closed also. Let's show this example on the real testing. So now kickoff is open, operations is open, and I would like to close the final task without closing the first two tasks. I click closed, and now I see the error message. The successor task SMM cannot be closed because the predecessor task operations is still open. Okay, let's try to close the operation task without the kickoff task closing. Click on operation and try to close it. The same error message, because kickoff is still open. That's why I can't close the operations. Okay. Then I can close the kickoff. After that, the operations task can also be closed. As you see, the system gave us the possibility to close the operations. The same thing with SMM. So there is the way to set the dependencies between tasks and also to set the tasks order. Thank you.
That's it for using Gantt chart in managing your task dependencies in Zoho projects. See you in our next video. Help us grow our community. Hit like, subscribe, and share this video to people you know. Do you have questions or clarifications? Send them our way at knowhow@customerization.ca.